Hi friends, this is Leela. Welcome to my channel. Up to now we are seeing about this observables concept and all the things we are seeing. So we have seen all the RxJS observables and also we have seen the operators, how to apply the operators to the observables also we have seen. So we can apply operators to all type of observables. Okay. Now, before closing this observables concept, RxJS, we need to know another important concept, that is nothing but subject. Okay. What is this subject? Subjects is used for component communications, okay, for the component communications, okay. Subject is not also nothing but it is an observable only, but when we are writing, when we are creating an observable, we have seen that observable dot next, we will be writing inside the observable, but subject has this different situation. We can write that next outside the observable, okay. Let's see with an example. So for example, if you see previously in the Angular, we have seen for the component communication, we have seen about the event emitter. Okay, we can achieve the component communication through the event emitter. First we will write through the event emitter and then after we will write with the subject how we can differentiate between those two. Here for example, see, here we have a users component. Okay, if I add a button here, users component. So if I click any button in this user component, in this users component, if I click that button, so it should invoke method in the app component. Okay, it should invoke variable, it should show some data in the app component. So how we can do that one? Let's see. So in the users component here, I am adding a button. So div. Okay, I will be adding one button. Let's assume div. Okay, here I will be adding one button. And what I will try to do is I will try to add a button here. Let's add the button. Now here button type is equal to anything, button or anything. So just what I will try to do is user add added or something like this I want to add. So on click, what I need to do, on user added click or something like this I added, so a method. Now what I will be doing is in the TS file I will be writing the method. Okay, so let's keep this method aside. Now what I need to do, so if somebody clicks on that button, I need to show some data in the app components. Let's go to the app component. Okay, here in this app component, here at the down I will be writing some code, something like div. Okay, so user added button click. Okay, so I am adding the some text here. If you see the text here, if you refresh that page will be refreshed here, you will be able to see that user button, user added button click. So let's go to the code and let's write it into this one so that it will come down. Now if we see the output here, these all things will go, and here you will be able to see that user added button clicked. So this text should be appeared whenever we click on this button only. It should not appear like this. So what can we do here? We will write the ngif directive so that star ngif is equal to some method we will take, some variable we will take. Okay, so we have one variable user added, so we will make it default as false here in the TS file. So if we go to the top TS file and here I can write user added is equal to false. For the first time I will keep it false only. Okay, so now if I refresh this one, so now this one is not appearing. So when we click on this button only, we need to show the text. How we can show? So now we will take one service. Okay, so we already have one service, that is nothing but user.service.ts. okay, so user.service.ts, here I will add here user added, okay, event or something like this. Okay, new event emitter, I will be having event emitter and it will be taking of type boolean. I can add this boolean. Okay, I have added this event emitter, should be imported from the Angular core. Now what I will try to do is here I will try to write a method user add user or something like this. Okay, add user, I will try to add a button here. So what I will try to do is that user added, okay, user added event dot emit, we will be emitting that, and also you will be emitting true. Okay, when we click on this add user, I will be emitting an event of true. Now I will be taking this one, where I need to do here in the user component.ts, I need to call this user service. So that means I need to inject the user service, private user service as user service. Okay, so let's inject that one, and here when user click, I will user service dot add user. I will call this method. Okay. So whenever we call this method, automatically what it will do, use from user dot service. So it will emit the data of true. So we need to catch that one in the app component. So if you go to the app component.ts, and here also you need to catch this one. So how we can catch? Again, we need to inject the user service. Private user service is equal to user service. Okay, so in this user service, and if we go to ng on init, okay, so here app we are not having ng on it, right? So right implements on init. Okay, so on init, what I will be trying to do is, so I will take here ng on init. I will try to implement ng on init. So in this ng on init, what I will try to do, so this dot user service dot user added event. We need to take this, what is that method, user service is there. Okay, we need to import this user service. Let's import the user service. Okay, so we will get an intelligence here, user added event. We need to subscribe to this one. Okay, dot subscribe, and we will be getting the data. So that what we will try to do, this dot user added, user added is equal to the data. We'll apply the data here. Okay, so now if we try to check the output here, let it refresh. Okay, it's refresh. Now I click on this user added, immediately see, you're able to see the data. So what is happening here, using this third party user service, where whenever the user clicked on this one, so we are executing the method in the user service, that add user, and this one is emitting an event. So whoever is listening to this event, okay, whoever is listening to this event, whatever the component, it may be app component, it may be any other component. So it will send the, it will try to send the data. Okay, if it tries to send the data, here we are saving the data in the, we are sending only Boolean value. So we are saving that one in here, so that it is appearing. So this is how we will be doing this one in the event emitter. Okay, so this event emitter also, we can do this type of concept, and also we can do the same concept using the subjects also. Using subjects is the most recommended way in the Angular. Why? Because due to the performance issues and all those things, than event emitter, subject performance will be very nice. So that is the reason all the people will be using subjects instead of this event emitter. Okay, so now we will try to implement this one in the subject. So the same concept, if you want to implement in the subject, you need to go first to the user.service.ts. If you go here, user.service.ts, so just change it to subject here. Okay, subjects, this should be imported from the rxjs. So subject of boolean, so same thing, is a generic type. Now here, instead of keeping this emit, what we need to send, next. So in the observable, we have already seen how to send that data. Okay, so we'll be sending that using next. We'll be having next complete error, we'll be having, right? So the next you'll be using, so the next, the advantage of subject is, the next we are using outside the subjects. Okay, in the observable we will be using that new observable or observable dot create, and in that observable you'll be using that next. We cannot use that observer outside. So here we, in the subject, the benefit is we can use it outside. Okay, this dot username dot next. So in the same scenario, what we will be trying to do is, so here, so the next means it is sending the data as an observable. So for any observable, if we are having, if it is an observable, means it will be having a subscribe method. Okay, so we are subscribing it here. If you go and if you execute this code, okay, if you click on this one again, you'll get the same action. But here one thing what you need to do is, so the main thing you need to remember is, so whenever you are going outside this component, so right now when you are going outside this component, so that means when you are going away from this app component, right now app component will be present all the time, but if you are written in any other, some other component, means that that component will get destroyed. So whenever we are going out of this component, we need to unsubscribe this subject. So how we can unsubscribe this one? So here, user added, so you can keep any name whatever you want, user added subscription or something like this, you can add. Okay, of type subscription. So this should be imported from the rxjs. Okay, so if you see here, subscription from the rxjs. So now what I can do, and here we need to implement the on destroy. Okay, now here what I can do is, so I can copy this one, and I can do on ng on init, this dot user subscription is equal to, I can keep like this, and this one on ng on destroy, on destroy, I need to implement ng on destroy. So here I can do this dot, so don't forget to do unsubscribe all the time. So for observables little bit of performance issue you will be getting. So here you will be doing, so here if I refresh the same thing, the same output you will be getting. Okay, so if I go to the users and if I click on this one, so you'll be able to see the user add button, click here. Okay, so if you click here, you'll be able to see the user add. So this is how we will be implementing the subjects in the Angular. So you can also implement event emitter, also you can implement subject. Subject is the most recommended way in the Angular for the cross component communication. And also one thing you need to remember, when you are implementing the subject, don't forget to unsubscribe that one on the ng on destroy. So this is about the subjects concept in the Angular. So if you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comments below to this video. And if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.